Alright, yeah, we have not found the actual exit. However, it looks like this password... Is that the bear? We finally found the bear, guys! Now leave my back row alone! Leave Edwin B! He's done nothing. Oh, that was Zan. Zan'll fight your ass. Do this. Zan's all about bear murder. Unless bear murder occurs on him, which is looking likely here. Never mind. We're good. Zan's fine. He has a thunderous 19 hit points, so... Alright, I'm pretty comfortable with him being at 15. I don't think I'm gonna pop another healing spell on him.
Talk more full plate and packing steel.
Okay, quick save. This is how I live my life.
You need that.
Chunk, lead the way. Mostly because traps. Oh, I'm getting paranoid now.
Cool one, butt kicking for goodness.
I'm here to help.
Man, honestly, this map looks like something you could put together in like Doom Builder or something. I don't know. Uh-huh. Exactly, freaking lightning bolt traps or something. But I do guess that's probably a lightning bolt trap meant to send one down this hallway to bounce back and just completely fuck your party. Woo! Cutting it close there, Chunk. Hee-haw-hee-hee-hee. Been here long? No, and I don't intend to stay long either. No, none of us do, none of us do. Did you think I wanted this place? Did you think I wanted to languish here for years? Channeling all Truar, once the brining light of Tether? No. Not I. Now give me that wardstone, Buttercup, or I shall pluck your petals and watch ye rot. Another wizard. Like fucking dicks. Oh my god.
Come on
here. Where is he? I just like. Dick.
Again, you disturb me.
All right, Edwin. Edwin, this is on you. You're my battle mage. Oh, except he just globe of invulnerability himself, so you're what's known colloquially as maybe. Let's see what these wands cast. Yep. Bye, Edwin. Oh, I don't know what that was. Remove magic. Ha. Good joke.
The quest is vain. What is the point?
Zan, you're up. Nope, not haste. Spell thrust. Knock that shield down, please. Bye, shield. Edwin! Do your thing. And by your thing, I mean fuck this dude up. Oh, yeah. Edwin's gonna cast faster than you no matter what you do, old man. Ooh! Old man's not playing around! Dropped a lightning bolt on Edwin! Which managed to hit him three times and give him. Alright, Chunk, finish it. Oh, an acid arrow. Oh no, I'm gonna reload, I just wanna see. Chunk, how can you not hit this dude? What is he even doing? Doing the corner dance. It's wonderful. Alright, reload. Okay, so at this point, do I know this jerk-off's around the corner? I think I do. My real question should probably be, does he have a globe of invulnerability? No, this is before I...
Again, you disturb me, my
I could probably make this work with two wizards. I'm being cheeky about this. I should just rush him down the hall and we'd probably be okay. But where's the fun in that? Okay.
We're all doomed.
Oh, breaking jamming. Fuck him up. Oh, I don't know if that affected him. I have no idea if that worked or not. Let's find out with a fireball.
Life is so hollow.
And a horror speak. Now he's taking damage. All right. Need to horror the. Oh, no. Alright, no more cheeky. Gene's done with your bullshit. just like popping him with his wand of magic missiles just to interrupt his spells. Because I don't want him whipping a... Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't want him whipping a lightning bolt down this hallway, because that would be a bad day. Edwin, what are you even doing? Are you like... He's throwing daggers at Zan. That's a thing of beauty right there. What's his Thaco? What is his Thaco even? He has a Thaco of 24. He's like never gonna hit anything. Because he's just terrible. Zan just ignores him and gets on with his life. Dude has some magic darts and gold. That is it. Plus one darts. Wow. That's some disappointment. One thing I do have to say about this is that, like, the ability to rest everywhere, like, whenever you want, essentially, takes a lot of the sting out of the majority of fights in this, because it's like, one of the things about playing tabletop is normally, like, when you're adventuring, you've got to manage your resources, because you can't just, generally speaking, sleep everywhere. It's like, these games play a little... Oh, come on, Deskiel. No. Hello there. And you might be who? Another wayward spellslinger looking for a way out, or just another power-hungry fool trying to force the doors from the wrong side? Tell me, warrior, why is it that whatever you seek is always in the last place you look? Because you find it? Ha! The common sense answer in a place uncommon where sense does not rule the day. You're looking for something here, something of power and value, I am sure. And are just what it is and for whom you seek it. You do not wish to relinquish it. What do you have to say to that? I have a task plain and simple. You aid it or oppose it, but you will not ignore it. I ignore nothing here, and I see far more than you. I've been here long and have used my time effectively. Some fall or go mad, but I have learned. Do I understand this place? No, but I begin to. Store is what it brings for something long since forgotten. Perhaps when I remember it, we'll master it, perhaps not. But you are but an interloper, a messenger, and the power of someone else will remove you from afar. Do what you must. I can only gain in this. I win. I am released. I lose. I am released. Alright. Thank you for the follow, Zerifuse. And the reason Edwin is a woman is there is a cursed girdle of femininity, masculinity in this, and I think, you know, Edwina is a good joke, so I equipped it on him. Because, hey, why not? So naturally, we have another wizard and a pack of frickin' winter wolves in our grill, so I'm gonna run away. Hide around the corner. I'm just gonna wait for these guys to come to me. Like, alright, I can even fight them at this intersection here. I just don't want to be, like, in this area, because that wizard's gonna just, I'm sure, pelt me with horror. I'd fireball these guys, but, why not? I should have both. Or just one, because fireball AoEs are hard to predict. Whatever. Who's not in there? Come on, guys. Hallway is wide enough that you can all get in there and maim this thing. Day, please. Thank you. Okay. Pelts, which I'm going to loot here momentarily, but first we sleep.
It shall be even okay. Bloodier than you hoped.
You tell him, Dorn. So we're gonna grab that. We're gonna stack everybody on the corner here. Debating on how I want to handle this. I assume this dude is a pretty experienced wizard. But at the same time,
again, you disturb me.
We might be able to just rush him and stab his face a lot, and he'll die. I don't know. I'm gonna throw a silence spell up there first, I think. At least I'm gonna try to.
May darkness prevail.
Alright, that should be close enough. And we'll just drop it like right there. Alright, I think he made his save. Yep. Oh, the dimension door. Where's he going? Is he just gonna wuss out? Nope, he's. Oh! Sneaky! The party-based confusion. Come back, and... Actually, don't. Where are your memorizations of glitter dust? Oh, do I have glitter? I probably have glitter dust on Edwin, don't I? Yeah. For whatever reason. Oh, it doesn't matter. I already exploded him. Apparently, Dorn had enough of his magical shenanigans and elected to introduce him to chunking. Alright. Hey look, it's the cloak we need. A scroll of stone skin. Ah, bullshit is occurring. Nope, 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 nope. Nope. Is he even gonna break this? Probably not. I assume that dude's probably like level 30 or something. Nope, we actually broke it. I'm impressed. Okay, so we have this stone. We have the cloak. We have a scroll of stone skin, which is great. We have this. Cloak was originally stolen from Chandelar by the powerful mage Semia, presumably for the powerful magics woven into the fabric. How it came to be in your possession is the fate of Semia are complete mysteries and ones not likely to be solved, much like the exact workings of the cloak, which would remain a mystery even to a powerful mage. Usable by Chandelar. Alright. Well, we have stairs up, so we might as well check it out. Huh. I could have sworn when haste wore off, it was supposed to fatigue, like, your entire party. I don't know. Ezekiel's scroll. Scribble, 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 as every mage must do. These walls will hold your power fast unless I walk right through. A boat I bade from birchen bark, but burned I did at morn. Rather I gather in this held spot than suffer my hands get worn. Fools this place has, and many more to come, I will greet and take what will, and in the end I will... Will I have all? Oh, I think so. I mock your prison owl as though you would care to listen. Are you even behind the walls? I see your symbols in the sky, but others too. Mistara, goddess of magic, my magical maiden. Why do you treat your children so? Do you give the sparkle of magic only so it cannot be used? A lesson in humility for those on the verge of true power? Drop your robes and wands and staves or forever be trapped with your self-importance and pride? Perhaps, but I will not shed that which I have earned just to walk the skies again. I shall profit from this. I will play outside your rules. This place will bring it all to me in time, though I can't take it elsewhere. No, you can't take it with you, but you can stay with it and hold it tight. Perhaps with outside help? Bah. None but those who have learned can find this place again, and they will not interrupt the teachings. I will not bend. I will snap and strike back in time. Humility is so humiliating, and I will not suffer more. Power impotent is still preferable to power lost. Of course, perhaps the walls do not listen to such musings, and my writing is pointless. No matter, for tomorrow I shall wipe this clean and write anew. My verse gets better. One must have hobbies. Alright. Save. Let's go inside. Whoa. Just takes us right back where we came in. That's freaking okay. Oh, hey. The wardstone kicked in. We're back, you jerk.
Yes.
What do you need?
You return. You are proven capable, at least in this respect. Certainly, you have the will to change your personal ways as well. We are square and fair for the moment. I cannot guarantee that we will remain so, however, as your kind is to be scrutinized closely. Rather, a non-existent short-term memory as well, I'm afraid. You've done me a favor, now do yourself one. Behave yourself until you are of positive standing in the community. Be gone. I'm gonna stab that dude in the mouth at some point, I think. Okay, so what do we have? Thrilla's home. Will Gaul Spirit in? I remember very little of this expansion beyond that dungeon being a hellscape, so this is essentially going to be that name. Del's Verftanian. I wonder if he's like a Sverf Neblin or something. Gnomes. Takes a little while, almost like it reduces the time until you get 50. Oh, that would make sense. I mean, for all I know, they changed it, like, with the enhanced edition. Let me check. I don't think they even have, negates slow. No. I don't know. I remember that, like, this was back in the era in the tabletop game where if you had haste cast on you, it aged you a year. Alright, Ike, what you got? Step right up, folks, and hear the tale of dread placed before thee. Join with me as I, adventurer extraordinaire Elk Cassadian Vendar, lead yet another group of brave souls through the very seat of danger in the realms. To Durlag's Tower we shall go and witness the perils that have taken the lives of hundreds of courageous men and women. See the horror of the treacherous traps, feel the presence of the long languishing dead, marvel at the wondrous wealth buried below. Not for the weak of spirit, as I will not be held accountable for any heart failure during or after our expedition. Step up, one at a time. Ah, good people of noble blood, who would throw down the gauntlet at the face of chance. Come see the lengths a man must go to protect what's his. A special package deal of 60 gold for your entire group. Not that you would need a discount. Durlag's Tower, if I recall correctly, is like the big thing here. With this expansion. So yeah, sure, why not? When do we leave? This will fill my quota for this trip. We leave forthwith. Remember to kiss your loved ones goodbye, and you may never see them again. Meet me at the base of the tower. You would surely be killed without me, but fear not. Only I can enter where others fear to tread. Okay. That's quaint. Guys, go into the tavern, thank you.
Speak at ye, so listen up a moment or two.
Hurgen Stoneblade, a merry adventurous band be ye. Have I got adventure that'll make ye yearn for glory? I'm Hurgen Stoneblade, presently residing in Citadel Edbar. Well met. What adventure do you speak of? Glorious adventure indeed. You have heard of Durlak's Tower, mayhap? Yes, the haunted tower south of here, yes? What was wanted by me my granda's friend for a time, he went mad, ye see. Durlag Trollkiller was a dwarven hero of great renown. Single-handedly slew many a dragon, he did. Me Granda was a great friend of Durlag's. They adventured together until me Granda's untimely death several centuries ago. Go on. Me Granda was slain by an evil demon, but Durlag survived. Durlag kept Soultaker. Oh, really? It had been Granda's. He was going to send it to me mother, but he was betrayed. Sad tale, that. After Durlag built the tower, his family was replaced by doppelgangers. Nice. Durlag killed them all, but was driven mad by the act. He entrapped his tower heavily and forgot about Negranda's dagger. Soultaker's a dagger? Disappointment. When I heard the story as a youth, I went to retrieve the dagger myself, but was driven back by Durlag's devious traps. If you be interested, I wish to hire you to retrieve the dagger, Soultaker, be birthright. The tower has been penetrated somewhat by previous adventurers. I should think that the edge has been taken off the danger. What say you? We'll find your dagger if I'm able. Good fortune to you, then. I await your return here. Alright. We have Gelkin.
Full plate and packing steel.
Will no one take me over?
Back. Hey, your friend. How'd you like a ticket out of the alleys? I've got a key to a great batch of swag if you're interested, or are you too busy cutting purse strings tonight? Tell me more. Ah, you're an adventurous spirit, ain't ye? No doubt you've heard of the labyrinth of Durlag. Oh my god. Everybody's all about this Durlag's tower, and how she's been pillaged to soften the fat nobles go there with picnics. Well, the tower has, but below are dungeons untouched. I've a token, a ward to be sure, that gives entry to them. 'Tis yours if you'll but settle my tab so I can leave this place with all my limbs intact. Have I played Siege of Dragonspear? No, actually, I have not. What I'm planning on doing is finishing Baldur's Gate 1, and then probably taking a little bit of a break for probably a couple weekends, and then I'm probably going to play through Siege of Dragonspear. I've heard a lot of whinging about it, but most of it's about, like, I don't know how to phrase this in a way that's probably not going to offend people, so I'm not going to bother. So there's been a lot of complaining about, like, social justice warrior crap being plugged into it by Beamdog's writers. But everything I've read into it says that it's really just, like, one or two encounters, and I honestly don't care that much if the rest of it's pretty good. So I do have an interest in checking that out. Plus, it'll give me more experience for going into Baldur's Gate 2. Sure, you have a deal. Actually, how much of your tab? Oh, it is but a meager sum. I'm embarrassed I cannot cover it myself. 900 gold at a bar as a commoner. That takes work. Where did you, the likes of you get? Yeah, sure, why not? Bless your kindness. I'm off to pay me bill before I suffer any more interest of either sort from the innkeep. Oh, by the by, while I'm certain he could not find me here, the former owner of this little trinket may well be keeping an eye over Durlag Way to see if he can spot someone using it. Just thought I'd pass along the warning since he did me the favor. I'm sure he'll listen to reason, though. That's okay. We have reason in the form of sharp implements and death magic.
Fight kicking hot goodness!
This group is especially hopeless today.
Xan, quit being salty that our reputation is like shoe right now. I don't even know what it is. I know it's bad, though. Dislike. We're at a 5. I'll take it. Okay, so we can't see Durlag's from here. But he said it was to the south. see if I leave south if we'll be able to see. Come on, guys. No. Oh, no, there it is. Destination unreachable. Well, can I get there from the temple? Or are you gonna make this, like, a pain in my butt?
Butt kicking for goodness!
You tell 'em, Minsk.
Being a hero is hard work. Time to rest.
Quit whining, I'm goblins.
You no fight. You fight, you die!
You fight, you die. Give all gold and iron or you die. To simple choices, what I say or die. Die, die, die. No. Your hearts be brave, we rip them out and show them to you. Chill, attack. Alright, I seem to recall these dudes having, like... Oh, these aren't the art. Oh, that's a lot of hobgoblins. I mean, I'm not worried at all because we're just going to sleep the entire group and then murder them all in their sleep. I wish Fireball were more party friendly. I would totally love to lob a Fireball into that group. And yeah. This is ending about exactly as I thought it was going to be. People hate this ending, really. The thing that I've heard about is that, like, there's some NPC, I've never heard it specified what NPC it is, that they, like, give some backstory in Siege of Dragonspear, and, like, some people were not a fan of the backstory that they gave to this NPC. And I can, like, I can understand that, because it's, like, from what I have gathered, it's an NPC that plays a prominent part in Baldur's Gate 2. So I can understand that kind of, like, drawing some ire. However, remember the name of the dagger that they talk about in Durlag's Tower, Soul Taker, I assume. Because Siege of Dragonspear actually has ties in it. That's actually kind of cool that they're gonna, like, tie stuff like that in. Like, I can appreciate that. Alright, we can't get there from here, but we have a side area. Which...
I must rest.
Part of me wants to say that this area is, like, full of spiders. That might be to the north, though. I just remember there's, like, one wilderness area out here where... if you rest a lot, you can, like, chain spawn sword spiders, and I used to use it a little bit for grinding back in the day. It might be this one, because I hear spider noises. What? Oh, shit. Oh, it's a lesser basilisk. I was not expecting to bump into basilisks out here. This is... I don't know if they have the petrification gaze, but we stunned it, so yeah, I was gonna say it's gonna be dead here in a moment. Whatever. It's a little stinking cloud, which would be great, except it will just, like, destroy our party. I mean, like, we'll give it to Edwin, why not? But I'm not gonna use it.
A squeaky wheel gets the kick.
Oh, yep. Okay, they do have the petrification gaze, and naturally, they just insta-gibbed Chunk, because what else are they gonna do? Okay. Ooh, they can, in fact, petrify. And we have some flins, which don't particularly worry me. They don't particularly worry me, except for when they kill my main character. Salt, salt, salt.
Butt kicking for goodness.
Man, that's rough. I was not expecting to be bumping into basilisks out here. I don't know if this area is specifically, like, expansion content. It might be. Why do you see the dragon spear to polish it? Oh, obvious bark. You're a card. Protection from normal missiles.
You point, squeaky wheel gets the kick.
There are other less appropriate jokes that could be made about dragon. Oh, we still have this ward stone. See, I'm curious then what happens if we actually use this thing. Unless this is the one to get into Durlag's tower. And not the one that was given to us by that mage, which would probably make more sense. We'll give it back to Chunk, because he's a dwarf. Okay. They get to kill the dragon to win the game. Now that just makes far, far too much sense, Zarathus. Too much sense. This is Dungeons and Dragons. We can't have logic in this house. Okay, so I think... Ooh, where were these guys at? Like, they just murdered my party. All right, they're right down here. Oh, shit. Oh, Minsk, why? That is, like, such bullshit. Oh, my God. I'm just gonna save scum this like a motherfucker. Who's got the best save against petrification? 11. 12. 10. All right, Minsk and Dorn, you guys are leading on the petrification. Welcome to Statue Brigade. You got a 50-50 on this. Oh, nope. Again! Nope! Again! Nope! Oh, this is just great. There we go. Yeah, once they got the gaze off, like, I think they can only do it once. I hope they can only do it once. 1400 experience! Obvious bark, that is wildly inappropriate. I do not know what would have coaxed you into saying that. Potion of Mirrored Eyes is helpful. I actually might have one of those floating around, or I may have sold it because I'm an idiot. I think I probably sold it, guys. Vulnerability, Master Thievery. Alas, no Potions of Mirrored Eyes. I might have scrolls. Scroll of Weakness. I don't even know why I'm carrying that around. Acid. Yeah, that's missiles. Now we're just gonna brute force this. Zan, you're gonna have a bad day here, and for that I am kind of sorry, but not really. Alright. Zan, pray. Pray that thing is horrified by you, and it is! Oh! But you cannot run the petrification game. Alright, I need to know how many of them are up here. I saw at least two, one of them which is actually like a legit... Oh, that's a greater basilisk! Oh my god! Oh my god! This is bad! Wow! Like, I cannot believe they would throw something in with like characters this low, because like... Flesh to Stone is, like, I think a 5th level spell? Or Stone to Flesh, rather? Oh, I'm just trying to think of ways that... Because these things are gonna be immune to sleep. I think for the time being, I'm just gonna have to, like, go around. Because... Especially with that Greater Basilisk, which is apparently, like, if its gaze hit you, not only does it petrify you, but it also chunks you, so... Only place you find them in the open, might be a few in dungeons, but very few. Alright, I can understand why. That is like no joke up there, because there's at least two more of the lesser ones. Replace level, you go back potion. Yeah! I can definitely see that, and that's something that I will try to keep in mind, because I'm all for levels. Okay, this should take us to Durlag's now. I mean, people are slowly getting there. Chunk's actually right on another fighter level, which is exciting. My mages are naturally nowhere near leveling. And it's not like level 6 is a particularly exciting... Seriously? You're waylaying me with kobolds. Like, it's not even worth... It's not even worth death magic. 4 kobolds. Nature's deadliest killers. Alright, to their legs. Oh, are you the dude looking for your thing, or are you our tour guide? I think you're a tour. Step right up. Welcome to Brave New Age of Mercantile Expansionism, ladies and gentlemen. A brave new age where we make money off of death itself. Money off honor, my poor children. Money off loss of pain and longing. Money off of ravaged beauty and tainted honor. Money off of a man gone mad. Now, all my dear voyeurs, ask not what you can do for me, but what I can do for you. And what can you do for me? Aye, selfish one, ye ask it right and true. No false piety hidden in your bloated skull. Well, if you be asking, a seller of cynicism and a merchant of mischief I be. You're so dead set on losing yourself in that toad-like tour, I can assist in assuring you that you don't take all your pretty gold with you. Oh, we have a shop. Darts of stunning. Ooh, these are very powerful because you throw like four of them around. Yeah, I noted that, Zerafuse, that those lesser ones are worth a lot of experience points. Correct. Obvious bark. I remember, I would say, like I said, I remembered that hell maze outside of the town, but like this part and forward, I do not remember very much of at all. 7,000 XP if you can take down the greater. Oof. That is incredibly tempting. Incredibly tempting. Okay, so we've cleared out 10 antidotes. That worries me. Well, I think Icewind Dale has a lot of bullshit in it. But this expansion, I remember not enjoying much of what this expansion added to the game.